DeFi, short for Decentralized Finance, emerged a couple years ago as a term in financial technology. It's crypto for, we're cutting out the middleman. Well, actually, it's a bit more idealistic than that. It's part of an open source and blockchain technology ethos. Decentralized finance expands access to a much broader range of possible participants. And when you take out the intermediaries and flatten the hierarchies, you often wipe out all these extra layers of costs, timing, and friction. DeFi drives innovation. Traditional financial institutions act as gatekeepers, or often hurdles, to would-be participants. Say maybe a small business that needs capital for growth, but doesn't check all the right boxes. There could be other financing options that are a perfectly good fit, but the more creative solutions just aren't going to make it through the bottlenecks of these centralized players. Decentralization is a defining characteristic of blockchain technology. People who live in countries all over the world can transact with digital currencies. DeFi builds that idea out into applications such as smart contracts, stablecoins, and lending platforms. For instance, Stronghold Capital participated in a syndicated loan to a Web3 research firm through a blockchain-based investment platform. Several years back, disruption was a buzzword in fintech. This is a similar concept and part of an ongoing cycle of disintermediation. Money and power can conglomerate, but the financial incumbents are often too big to innovate. So they face recurring challenges from savvy, nimble startups and outsiders. Through our investment arm, through our payments ecosystem, and our SHX token, Stronghold has been expanding the reach of decentralized finance. We're supporting the next generation of fintech visionaries, the ones who are just starting to imagine the technology that will take us through the next wave of disruption, disintermediation, and decentralization.